Now to that Kentucky nanny who captured our heart. She ran through 400-degree flames barefoot to save a 5-year-old little boy in her care. Well, this morning she was reunited with him and his very grateful father. Jack has the story.
Break out the tissues and save one for me. If our story with the nanny last night got you tearing up, wait till you see her with little Aiden.
It was the moment Aiden had been waiting for. Alice and Myatt wheeled into the waiting room this morning and into the arms of the little guy she saved. She was overcome with emotion. Allison has been Aiden's live-in nanny for just 2 months, but you'd never know that by looking at the two together. She feels it's a bond worth risking your life for.
I just saw flames all down the hallway, and then the bathroom door was on fire because I had shut the bathroom door before this big fire. So there was no way to avoid the flames. But before I had even looked at the fire or anything, I was yelling for Aiden, and he said he was in his room underneath the covers.
Allison looked at the wall of flames and didn't hesitate, running barefoot to Aiden as the skin on her feet burned off.
The first and second time, I didn't feel anything until I was standing on the carpet where it wasn't on fire, and my feet were in excruciating pain. But it was dark upstairs, so Aiden couldn't see anything, and I had him in my arms. And then when we got to the steps, and then we just went down the steps, and I just grabbed my purse, and I was thinking, I was like, oh, man, I dropped my cell phone. Now I can't call anybody. So I grabbed JB's business card off my desk, jumped in the minivan, got Aiden in and whatnot. And then we went to Lucy's house, the neighbor down the street. And I was explaining to Aiden on the way to Lucy's house that he was going to have to run and ring on the doorbell until somebody came to the door. And that's what he did. And he was very brave, and he just, you know, got out of the van as soon as I opened the automatic door. And he ran up there and, you know, rang the doorbell till Lucy came.
In maybe the most touching moment, Aiden explained what Allison means to him.
Well, I love her so much. I miss her when she's gone and stuff.
Aiden's father, JB, who's a single dad, calls Allison an angel, saying he is lucky to have found her.
Yeah, my work, you know, I get busy, and I advertised for a nanny, and she was, I think, the sixth person I interviewed, and her and Aiden just clicked right away and got along, and I just followed my instincts. And of course, she had impeccable references, and she moved in and just started taking over to help me out with him. And you know, God brought her into our world, that's for sure. Well, when I flew in from Minnesota that morning, I came straight to the hospital and saw her on the bed, and to realize what she did, you know, saving my son's life. You know, you can't thank someone for that.
Yeah.
There's nothing you can do to repay them for taking that kind of a risk. And then when I went to the actual house and stood in the hallway that she ran through, I realized there, as the chief said, there was only 1 minute left. I mean, there's no words to put how grateful I am to have my son with me, how grateful I am to have Allison in our world. And it's just, you know, one of those things that you can't put any value on. There's no price to be paid. It's a debt that will never be able to be paid.